Hey everyone, Britt and Chris Carmichael here, bringing you the Elevated Life series, where we teach you simple mindset shifts to create radical transformation in your life. Today's topic was inspired by one of you, and we'll be talking about how to forgive yourself even when it's hard to forgive other people.
Yeah, this is such a big deal. You know, forgiving someone or forgiving yourself, going the extra extension and forgiving yourself, is one of those ways where you can get out of the past. So many people wonder why their present's not that great, or they wonder why their future doesn't seem so wonderful. And a lot of times it's because they've spent a lot of time living in the past. And so you have to come to a place where you can say, hey, I've done certain things and certain things have happened to me, and it's time to let all of those things go.
Yeah, so we're going to share four steps to forgive yourself, because if in order to forgive anyone else and create that sense of freedom in your life, you have to start with yourself. And self-forgiveness is one of the main modules that I teach in my online school called Shine School, where I teach you how to learn to love yourself. And I even wore my shirt, Love Yourself, today in honor of this self-forgiveness practice. And these four steps are going to help walk you through that simple process so that you can finally, again, tap into that feeling of freedom and release and let go of all that resentment from the past. So before we dive into these four tips, just take a moment to say hello. Where are you watching from? Is this your first time tuning in? And does this resonate with you? Do you feel like, yep, there's some self-forgiveness work that I need to be doing right now? And I want you to just be intentional about this video. While you're watching, you know, allow those thoughts and those feelings to arise that need to be released. And Chris will kick it off with the first step on how to forgive yourself.
Yeah, so the first step is face it. So you have to face whatever you've been pushing aside for forever, and you have to turn around, you have to face it head on. A lot of us suppress things that we've done that we feel are negative, and we push them, and what ends up happening is the part of us that went through the experience still lives there, and the rest of us kind of moves on. And that's why we can't get past it. We have to go back and recognize that part of ourselves that may still be living in that moment and say, hey, I see you there. It's okay, you can come forward now. So as you turn to face it, you'll build that connection with that younger self, with that previous you.
Yeah, there's a phrase that I just love, and it's, you've got to feel it to heal it. And it's so true. And face it is the first step. If you're avoiding and you're, you know, like putting it in the closet, then you're never going to be able to fully release it. It's when we become our holistic self is when we face the deepest, darkest, scariest places within us, and we don't cut off any parts of ourselves, even the traumas and even the pains. When we have the courage and willingness to look at all of ourselves through and through, that's when we'll truly know self-love and freedom and forgiveness.
Yeah, so the second step is to accept it. So once you've faced it, now accept it. And what the acceptance part is just saying like, hey, this is an experience that happened to me. I can deal with that. Rather than going, no, this never happened, turning our head, like Britt was saying, turning our head away from it, suppressing it more. So we faced it now. The second part is to accept it. Accept that it's happened in your past experiences.
Yeah, there's this great Zen saying that is, you'll end all suffering when you just accept it. And I think that this is so simple, yet so difficult. We make it so difficult, but it was like when my mom had the stroke, the only thing I could do to make it better was to accept that this was happening rather than resist the truth of what was going on.
Yeah, it's so much easier to start finding solutions when you're really dealing with the problem. If you pretend that the problem doesn't exist, the problem still stays. You know, we can't avoid that elephant in the room. We have to go, oh my gosh, it's there. Okay, but now what do we do about it?
So what's your big elephant in the room? Just take a moment, like I said, to be intentional about this video today, about this chat. You know, self-forgiveness requires vulnerability, and it requires courage and true inner strength to do this kind of healing and transformative work. So just go easy on yourself, but also be honest with yourself and ask yourself, is there something that I've been avoiding? Is there something that I need to heal?
Yeah, is there something that I'm holding on to? Yeah. You know, feel where that weight lives inside you and say, what is it that I can do today to start releasing that?
Yeah, and the third step on self-forgiveness is how to find the lesson. I always say search for the silver lining. In all of our messages, you hear that come through all the time. And when you can finally use your conscious awareness to find the lesson in what life has dealt you, that's when you finally have that freedom from that pain of the past. You now have the wisdom that it was trying to show you. Without the pain and suffering, you wouldn't learn the lesson. And once you learn the lesson, you can end that pain and suffering, and you no longer have to continue that same cycle with the belief that, wow, this always happens to me. No, learn the lesson.
Yeah, this is the step that really allows you to move on, because what you're saying here is, how can I turn a mistake into a teaching? And then how can I learn from that and move forward? Mm-hmm. And as you're turning a mistake into a lesson, it becomes so much easier to deal with. If it just stays a mistake, and oh, I hate this about myself, and I can't believe I ever did that. But if you say, hey, I did that, I'm okay with that, what did I learn from it? Now it's so much easier to move on. So this step is the most important, is to find that silver lining. What was the lesson? How did you grow? How did you change? What did it force you to do? What did it force you to stop doing? Yeah. So start thinking about those things so that you can realize that a lot of times people and situations are put in our lives to force us to grow. You know, people ask about soulmates all the time. And the big deal about soulmates is the relationship may suck because it forces you to grow. You have to get out of that comfort zone. You have to get to a place where you say, oh my gosh, I've got to deal with this stuff. And the soulmates and other people and situations can bring those things out in you in a super big way.
Yeah, so I want to do a quick experiment with you guys. I believe that there are a handful, a very small handful of life lessons that we're here to learn. And they happen to us in our own unique way, our own unique expression. But the underlying lesson seems to be the same. So I want to know, what is the lesson that you've learned from some of your past pains or traumas? And what big lessons or themes, reoccurring themes, has life taught you? I want to know. Leave that in the comments and let's see how similar our life lessons are. I mean, if we get down to the bottom of all of it, to me, the life lesson is always rooted in learning how to love. And learning how to love yourself first makes it so much easier to love other people. Because if you can't accept the darkness within you, then it's going to be impossible to accept the darkness within others.
Yeah, and if you do these steps and you realize how to forgive yourself and you start working on those kinds of things, the other people are just way easier. Because we're so much more critical and we say so many things internally to ourselves that's just so hateful and so negative. And once you start saying, I'm not gonna do that anymore, I'm okay with being me, I'm okay with the things that have happened, like just forgiving a guy for pulling out in front of you or for the person getting in front of you at line at the supermarket or whatever is so easy. That becomes such an easy place, you know, to be at and to sit at and to realize that, like, I can let other people make mistakes too. Like, that's the big secret here. It's okay to make mistakes. It's okay to love yourself if you've made mistakes. And it's okay to love yourself as you heal from those mistakes.
And it's okay to move forward too.
Like, no one wants to talk about that, but it's totally fine. Like, we're all doing it. Yeah. And what you start to realize is that going through the self-forgiveness is you start to build compassion. You start to realize that other people are probably dealing with the exact same. They've got to forgive themselves from stuff. And it puts you in a connection with people in a very different way because you start tuning in and realizing that people are struggling. It's a struggle. Yeah. And if we realize that we're all struggling, we can all sort of hold each other accountable to be there, to heal, to, you know, be able to sit with each other while we're going through those dark nights.
Yeah. And the fourth step on learning to heal and forgive yourself is to appreciate the lesson. And you'll know that you've completed your forgiveness when you can finally look back at those life lessons with that wisdom, that knowing that, okay, I learned this powerful spiritual lesson that helped me grow. When you can look back at those experiences and no longer be stung emotionally on the inside by it, but rather you feel the sense of peace and like, oh man, I'm really glad that happened because I learned what not to do. I learned more about myself. I learned more about other people. And when you can appreciate the lesson, that's when you know your forgiveness has transformed into freedom.
Yeah, and think about what that does. Like, mm-hmm. Once you transform in that way, you become a better parent, you become a better spouse, you become a better friend because you've dealt with things. Because, you know, when you go through things, that's where growth happens. And growth doesn't happen while, you know, you're sitting relaxing on a beach. Like, that, it's not going to happen. It's when traumas come up and you move through them. Now, when your kids do it or when your friends do it or somebody else does it, you go through and say, hey, I know exactly how you feel. I've been there. I know it's rough, but here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to share this space with you so that you can move and relax and love yourself through this process as well.
Yeah. If you're just tuning in, we're covering four ways to forgive yourself and practice self-forgiveness even when it's hard to forgive other people. And the first one is to face it. Number two, accept it.
The third one is to find the lesson. And fourth, of course, is to appreciate that lesson.
Yeah, you guys are leaving so many amazing comments. I was in a relationship forced to literally sit in darkness and within my own darkness in order to see who I really am. I am grateful now, but I felt very raw at first, very naked.
Definitely.
Absolutely. I mean, think about how the caterpillar feels going into the chrysalis. It is a scary, a raw, vulnerable, it's a courageous act. But knowing with faith that when you go through these healing transformations, you're going to come out on the other side wiser and stronger and more authentically you.
Yeah, so you have to always go through the whole process with a big, big emphasis on love in your heart. And just the same way you would do if it was your best friend going through the exact same thing. Go through that process with it just, hey, it's okay. Everything's going to be okay. And when you do that with yourself, you start to be able to move through these transitions with much more ease. It doesn't take so long. You don't have to whine and pout about it. It's not that it's going to be easy, just that you'll be able to move through it quicker.
Yeah. And if you guys have any questions, if we've poked any buttons, if any emotions have arisen, or if any old memories or experiences are rising up for you to be healed and released, then go ahead and shoot us a private message or leave a comment below. We're here to support you along this self-discovery journey. We love guiding you through the darkness so that you can find your inner light and shine. We appreciate you guys tuning in every Friday to the Elevated Life series. If you love this message, please tag someone below or share this on your page. We appreciate you guys spreading the good vibes and the good karma all around. If you have a topic you'd like us to cover here on The Elevated Life, then leave it in the comments below, because we love answering your questions about transformation, healing, business, life, relationships, spiritual growth, whatever it is. I think next week we're going to be covering on how to build an authentic business for you. I think that was another topic that you guys wrote in with, and that just made me so excited. But today we felt like teaching you guys how to forgive yourself first so that it makes it easier to forgive others will give you that sense of freedom and inner peace to let go of those burdens and to release the weight that you've been carrying.
Oof. Yee. Have a good weekend, guys.
Have a great weekend. Thanks for tuning in to The Elevated Life. We'll see you guys next week.
Bye.
Bye.